So, before the year 2022 ended, I put up a poll on my YouTube community post, and among all, you have voted for these two, the Nothing Phone 1 and the Samsung Galaxy A73, to go against each other. So, I've decided to revisit both phones by using them daily to find out which phone is the better phone. First, let's talk about each of the phone's prices. As of January 2023, the Nothing Phone 1 is priced at RM1,999, which is about $453 USD for the 8GB RAM and 256GB storage variant. And the Samsung A73's price has dropped to RM1,760, which is about $399 USD. So is the higher price on the Nothing Phone 1 worth it? Well, let's find out. So the Samsung A73 comes with a Snapdragon 778G 5G chipset, and the Nothing Phone 1 comes with a 778G Plus, but both is a 6nm chipset. And after all the latest updates, both phones did not have any issues when I use it daily. Now the A73 was and still has been bug-free, while the Nothing Phone 1 was totally infested by bugs. But after the latest updates, all of those has just gone away. Now, in terms of how each phones hold heat, now I wouldn't say that both phones ran cool during a very heavy gameplay, but of course there's no overheating issues, which I'll dive in deeper in my gaming review later on in this video, especially how it feels in the hands when you game on this phone for a very long time. Now, in terms of weight, on paper, the Nothing Phone 1 is heavier and the A73 was about 12.5 grams lighter. Now, that might sound like it's a lot, but the Nothing Phone 1 did not feel significantly heavier. And like I said before, the Nothing Phone 1 always felt like you're using an iPhone. So if you're coming from the iPhone 12 series onwards, it will be highly familiar to you, where the A73 did feel as good as how the A series from Samsung has always been. So if I had to choose between which rear finish is better on my hands, my obvious pick would be the A73, as it did feel like a tiny bit less slippery to hold compared to the Nothing Phone 1, and the side frame on the A73 felt nicer compared to the squared design frame that the Nothing Phone 1 had. But of course, since I do use the iPhone 14 Pro Max as my daily smartphone, the Nothing Phone 1 didn't feel too alien to me. So I guess that this comes down to which type of design that you prefer. Now, speaking of design, while I do appreciate how the camera bump was nicely curved to the camera arrays, but we all have to agree on the uniqueness of the Nothing Phone 1's design, which was a very refreshing look. And even if you do or do not use the glyph interface, it does give that very unique look about the phone. So in terms of design, the Nothing Phone 1 wins, hands down. Then if you're like me who like to type the phone when it's on a desk, the good news is that both phones does not wobble at all. So I certainly love that about the phones. Then the placement of the ports and buttons are just a little different, where the Nothing Phone 1 has the volume rockers on the left and the power button on the right. And the A73 had everything on the right hand side, but there was no issues of reaching out to the buttons or having any accidental presses, like how it was when I used the Google Pixel 7 Pro, because of how awkward the placing of the buttons were. Now both phones have stereo speakers, and while both sounded great, I was leaning towards the Nothing Phone 1's audio quality because the bass was a little better and had overall better balance of the music and the vocals without needing to tweak the audio. So overall, from a hardware's perspective, other than giving the speakers a point for the Nothing Phone 1, I would give the point for the design too, and a point for the A73 for the overall finish and better durability of the phone, since the phone is not made of glass at the back, hence it's more durable in case you drop the phone. Now, looking at the phone's display, the A73's display size is slightly bigger at 6.7 inches compared to the Nothing Phone 1's 6.55 inches. Now, the Nothing Phone 1 has a 100 nits lower peak brightness at 700 compared to 800 nits on the A73. And while the brightness difference isn't really noticeable when using it daily, I found a significant difference if you use the phone under a very bright sunlight, as there were times where the Nothing Phone 1 screen was way less visible compared to the A73 when I use it in a harsh or a very strong daylight situation. Now, while I do appreciate how the Nothing Phone 1 had the more symmetrical bezels and the camera hole punch at the side compared to the middle on the A73, but the thing is that whether or not it's a mid-range or a flagship smartphone, Samsung has always been the best in the market when it comes to their displays, and this is the same for the A73. So yes, if I had to compare it side by side with the Nothing Phone 1, the A73 definitely produces an overall better image when consuming videos or any other content in general. Then from a display software's perspective, it is indeed very nice that there are customized options to change between the saturated and non-saturated mode, and even changing the white balance on both phones to cater on which color temperature that you want the phone to be. Then, since both phones have up to 120Hz refresh rate, so using the phone daily for scrolling and navigating between windows was nice and smooth. So I have no complaints of using this phone screen when I use it daily. Now, both phones have the exact resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels, so it is equally as sharp. But reading text on the A73 was more pleasing to the eye, especially when you do not turn on the dark mode, and both have the same Gorilla Glass 5 protection as well. And what I found nice is that both phones had a perfect automatic brightness adjustments, where usually it's the Pocos or the Samsungs that does a better job on the automatic brightness. So it's nice that the Nothing Phone 1 joins them to be one of the best adaptive brightness for the display. So it was a tough choice to choose between the both, but I would say that I would go with the A73, which had a slight edge for producing better color reproduction and a slightly brighter display when needed. So the cameras on these two phones could be a make or break on your purchase decision. And the question is that, is the bigger sensor on the A73 can beat the Nothing Phone 1 flat? Well, as a recap of the specs, the Samsung A73 has a massive 108MP f1.8 main lens, a 12MP f2.2 ultra-wide lens, a 5MP f2.4 macro lens, and a 5MP f2.4 depth lens. Yep, the last two lenses, which I call it useless lenses, so let's see how useful it is. Then the Nothing Phone 1 has a 50MP f1.9 main lens and another 50MP f2.2 ultra-wide lens. Yep, just two lenses, but at least they serve a useful purpose, right? Then as for the front camera, the A73 has a bigger 32MP f2.2 aperture lens and the Nothing Phone 1 has a smaller 16MP f2.5 lens. Now let's start with the high megapixel mode. As I predicted, if you don't zoom in into the image, it looks pretty identical to another, everything from the colors and dynamic range. Probably just the contrast on the Nothing Phone 1 was a tad bit darker on the areas of the trees, but not hugely noticeable. But of course, if you zoom in close to about 8 times, here's where you can see a sharper image on the A73 due to its higher megapixel count. But as said, not everyone needs to punch in and zoom in close after they've taken a shot. Now, to my huge surprise, both pictures for the ultra-wide lenses were extremely similar, and if it weren't for the watermark on the A73, you could not tell which is which, where the focal length and the dynamic range was on point and very same as well. Now, I'm not sure if YouTube's compression will affect the image color, but the only slight difference would be the fact that the greens were a bit more saturated on the A73 in a usual Samsung's fashion, but not too oversaturated. Now, since the images were quite similar on the high megapixel mode, you can expect similar results for the main lenses with similar details and colors for both phones. And unlike the ultra-wide lens, the saturation on the A73 was perfectly balanced on this main lens too. Now, in terms of the zooming capabilities, what's interesting is that the Nothing Phone 1 can zoom up to 20 times even with a smaller size sensor than the A73, which could only zoom up to 10 times. And another interesting fact is that if you compare the 10x zoom images on both, the Nothing Phone 1 seems to have a cleaner images, as you guys can see, which was mind-boggling because the A73 has a supposedly bigger 108MP sensor compared to the 50MP on the Nothing Phone 1. And even if you go down to 2x zoom, the Nothing Phone 1 had just a little more texture on the building. It's a very tiny difference, but yeah, it's there. Then comparing the rear portrait mode on subjects, both had excellent edge detection on the subject and the dynamic range on the blurred background was nice and smooth. But of course, the images were just a little saturated on the A73 when comparing both. But there were times where the A73 couldn't figure out which object to stay focused on, as seen in this second images on the leaves, where the Nothing Phone 1 did a better job over here. Again, here's where I felt like the depth sensor lens may not do what it's supposed to do. Now, as for portrait modes on humans, here's where the A73 did a better job when it comes to edge detection, not only for the person's hair on top, but also for the menu he was holding. However, the skin tones were a bit more natural on the Nothing Phone 1, looking at this particular second photo. Then going into the macro mode, yeah, the lens which I call useless, which a lot of people tend to love, so, okay. So yeah, in this particular first image, the A73 had better details and was sharp from edge to edge compared to how the Nothing Phone 1 was blurry at the edges. However, sometimes I found it a bit harder to focus on the A73 as seen in this particular second image, and I swear my hands were as stable as it can be. But as you can see in this third image, the Nothing Phone 1 continues to blow out the sides even more. Switching over to the night mode, starting with the ultra-wide lenses, I prefer how natural the light was on the Nothing Phone 1, and the images was even sharp too, probably because of the bigger ultra-wide sensor on the phone. And again, my hands were extremely stable and I even waited longer after taking a shot. Then the details on the sky on the second image was better on the Nothing Phone 1 too, as it was quite soft on the A73 and once again less sharp than the Nothing Phone 1. But if you do have significant amount of light, only then the A73 look nice, but then again, you usually would turn on the night mode when you don't have enough light, right? However, you start to see better images on the main lenses on the A73, making it very identical once again, and it was the same even at 2x digital zoom. Now, if you're planning on taking selfies at night, if the night lights are towards you, it will produce some nice images, but if you're taking a selfie with some lights behind you, the A73 will light up the face better, hence having better results in those situations. Now, switching over to daytime selfies on the portrait mode, not only the software processing knew which to keep in focus and which is the best background on the Nothing Phone 1 compared to the A73, I also preferred the more natural skin tones that the Nothing Phone 1 had, no matter the lighting was harsh or soft. Then as for video, both phones can record up to 4K 30 frames per second. Then the ultra-wide video was equally as good, where the A73 was a bit better in terms of the image quality and of course a little more saturated as per usual. Now the image stabilization was also great, and there was some weird focus issues at the beginning of the video whenever I record a video on the Nothing Phone 1, but after that it was all good. Now both video footages look great on the main lenses too, and performing very well in my dynamic range test when I pointed a camera against the sun, so it did show how great that these two cameras were. Then as for image stabilization, both were decent as how a mid-range phone would usually perform without adding the extra stabilization mode that will eventually bring down the resolution as well. Then as for the front video, the Nothing Phone 1 joins the other Chinese smartphone makers to only give us up to 1080p recording. Compared to 4K 30 frames per second recording on the A73. So you'll have a better video footage on the front camera on the A73. However, the image stabilization wasn't at best on both phones because I expected it to perform better. Now, if you're planning on taking videos at night, I felt like the video on the Nothing Phone 1 was a bit better at low light situations, especially on recording towards the writing of the lighted words of the Italian.
What's up? Slappers.
And if you're planning to do some vlogging at night, once again, because of its higher recording resolution, the footage looked better on the A73. And speaking of vlogging, let's see how both cameras' audio video recording is, so you can be the judge.
Alright, so this is a front video camera test and also an audio test recording between the A73 and also the Nothing Phone 1. As usual, the Nothing Phone 1 can only record up to 1080p, as for the Samsung Galaxy A73 can record up to 4K. So when it comes to video recording and resolution, obviously the Samsung Galaxy A73 wins this. But of course, you can be the judge in terms of the audio recording on which you think is a better vlogging phone to use.
So with this, guys, with all of these tests, let me know which camera that you thought was better. And if you're enjoying this video so far, a nice big thumbs up would be very much appreciated. And a subscription would be very sweet too. Thank you very much in advance. Now, as for the battery specs, the A73 has a larger 5000 mAh of battery, which I consider quite necessary for a mid-range smartphone. And the Nothing Phone 1 had 500 mAh less. Now, battery drain on the Nothing Phone 1 was better with 5% battery between the both at the beginning stage of using the phone after it's fully charged. Now, in terms of the screen on time, after all of the updates, I was getting an average of 7 hours of battery life on the A73, and to my surprise, even with a lower 500 mAh, the battery on the Nothing Phone 1 was averaging at about 10 hours plus, beating the A73's daily battery life test when I was at 10% battery. Now, these tests are done with the Force 120Hz refresh rate and the dark mode turned on for both phones. So, I guess size does not matter, eh? That's what she didn't say. Then charging performance on the Nothing Phone 1 is better at 33 watts compared to 25 watts on the A73, because the Nothing Phone 1's rear is made of glass, of course, and the phone also has wireless charging up to 15 watts and reverse wireless charging up to 5 watts as well. So the obvious winner over here is the Nothing Phone 1 when it comes to the battery department. Now, before we go into the software comparison between both phones, let's talk about a software that I found extremely useful for many daily situations for me, which is NordVPN, the sponsor of this video. So have you come to a situation where a friend from another country talks about a particular show on Netflix that you should check out, only to find that it's not available in your country? Well, it has happened to me many times, and here's where NordVPN comes in. Because with a single click on the location that the show is available, you'll be connected instantly and voila, you can watch those content immediately, hassle-free. And what's extra sweet is that there's no bandwidth throttling, as NordVPN encrypts all of the traffic, so your internet service provider won't be able to slow down your streaming speed. And in fact, NordVPN is the fastest VPN out there and is available on every major platform on Windows, Android, iOS, macOS, Linux, and even your Android TV supports NordVPN, so you can easily stream your favorite content directly on your TV as well. Cool, right? And on top of that, NordVPN also helps to defend you from everyday online cyber threats like malware and trackers scanning your files before downloading them, thanks to the amazing NordVPN CyberSec, also known as the threat protection feature, so rest assured that you're always protected. To learn more, check out the link in the description below to get a big discount and a special offer at nordvpn.com/adamlobotv, as there is a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee. And thank you, NordVPN, for sponsoring this video. So one of the biggest strengths of Samsung phones these days, including this mid-range series, is how they have promised future Android and security updates even more than Google's very own Pixel devices. And Samsung has lived up to its promise, because as of the recording of this video, the A73 is at Android version 13 with the latest One UI version 5, which I absolutely love and still is my preferred Android skin, and the Nothing Phone 1 is still at Android 12 with Nothing OS version 1.1.7. Now, as much as I did not come across any issues when I used both phones daily, and while the Nothing Phone 1's UI was new and refreshing, but there was a sort of familiarity of Samsung's One UI since it has been in the market way longer than Nothing. So I would say that if you jump from any other smartphone to the Nothing Phone 1, it might take a little getting used to, and some people have said that the UI was very close to the iPhone, and I would totally disagree on that. Now, this is because in my humble opinion, I feel that the UI is a combination of OnePlus from the yesteryears and a little pinch of Pixel UI in it. And from a comparison standpoint, I do prefer the slightly more straightforward approach that the One UI has. On the A73, for example, going into the settings was way faster on the A73, where you could see the gear icon when you scroll at the notification menu, compared to how you'll need to scroll down twice to see the gear icon over there on the Nothing Phone 1. Now again, this is not a huge issue, but it's worth mentioning since this is a comparison video. And while the settings menu was clean and as straightforward, there always seems like there's more options on the One UI skin, for example, the connection menu. And I always love how Samsung puts the looking for something else below to ensure that you go to where you want to be in a very quick click. Now, as mentioned, the Glyph interface is something that I don't use myself daily, and I still feel that it is a bit of a novelty, cool feature. So I wouldn't say that that is a decision maker of sorts, but then some people do really use it, so it depends on the individual as well. So from a software's perspective, I do prefer the software experience on the Samsung Galaxy A73. So here's a point for that. And while there's nothing wrong with the Nothing UI, pun intended, I felt that instead of trying to go back with Carl Pei's time at OnePlus to have that kind of UI, they should have a unique look on its own, just like how the Nothing Phone 1's hardware is. So the gaming test was done based on Genshin Impact, since it's more graphic intensive. Now on the Nothing Phone 1, it performed at best at medium settings, 60 frames per second with motion blur turned off, where the game ran smoothly without any lag or micro stutter, where there were no huge battery drain issues, where it went down about 3% battery after 20 minutes of continuous gameplay, which was great. And to my surprise, I thought that the edges might be a little uncomfortable during a very long gameplay, but the good news is that it wasn't. Then the phone only became a little warm about 40 minutes of continuous gaming. Then the settings were the same on the Samsung Galaxy A73, and the gameplay experience was also very similar to the Nothing Phone 1, and the phone was a little less warmer compared to the Nothing Phone 1 at about 40 minutes in, and since the phone had a matte finish at the back, the overall grip was better when I was playing game for a very long time compared to the Nothing Phone 1. So in my humble opinion, when it comes to gaming, I prefer the gaming experience on the A73 just a bit better because of how it was a bit more comfortable to game on and it was less warm during a longer gameplay. And I have to say that the Nothing Phone 1 was a tad bit responsive when it comes to performing those high intensive animation when doing the special moves. So in conclusion, which should you get? Well, although the Nothing Phone 1 was a pretty disappointing phone when it first came out, it is great that all of the software updates have improved the phone's camera and of course the huge jump in battery life. Because before the update, I thought that the A73 will totally beat out the Nothing Phone 1 flat. But that was not the case, especially after all of the software updates. And even without the latest Android 13, my pick, if I had to choose between both phones, would be this Nothing Phone 1. But who cares what I think? What's more important is what you think. So let me know in the comment section below which one would you choose and let's discuss it over there. And do check out my previous comparison video over here.